of Heating, and I'm representing Eindhoven University of Technology in the Netherlands. So, as a group in Eindhoven, we are mainly focusing on development of microstructured reactors for different applications and mainly for hydrogen production and conversion storage and also for fine chemicals. Inka Professor Kessel, who is in the audience, will present a plenary lecture on Friday, especially devoted to this area, so I only shortly introduce speeches. So there are mainly reactors with very small dimensions of reactor channels, and magically what we do is a catalytic microstructure reactor, so we don't work with pelletized catalysts as such, but only use steam fumes deposited on the walls of the microchannels. So hydrogen technology is a new area, and the isotope topic at the moment, and the main idea in the transition period is to produce hydrogen from different hydrocarbon fuels. And for this particular project, we want to use a diesel, which can be converted to hydrogen rich gas. And one particular problem here is the size of the system, especially the size of the water gas sheet unit, which is the largest part of the fuel processor, and my talk mainly will be devoted to this reactor catalyst development. So as a group in Eindhoven, we started these activities approximately 10 years ago, and firstly on a small scale for portable power applications. It's typically in the range of 500 watts, and later on we moved on to residential applications and the scale of only 1 kilowatt range. And the next step in the coming few years is just development of utility power, so processors for 5-10 kilowatt range. And particular problem here is you need the shift step, which actually can be avoided with this low power output processors. So the targets of future goals, so I can say 2012 from now, is maximum power output 1 kilowatt, and it has to provide efficiency and a size for the total volume of the system. If you see in a little bit, it has to be decreased by almost half from now, so it has to be below 150 liters. So this is actually rather ambitious task, and our project was devoted mainly to decrease one of the largest reactors in the system. And also, of course, the durability has to be considerably improved because present catalysts, which are copper single side, also serve a longer time and a pyrophoric. So, as I mentioned, the boundaries for our system was the use of fuel, just the Euro 5 standard, which could be introduced in 2012. And we did it as a represented 1:9:1 ratio of two hydrocarbons, which can be fed a 3-bar and also air produced as the oxygen source, and output has to be 5 kilowatts output electric, and of course the same amount of heat will be produced. So a few words about the processor itself, why it's so important. You can see actually the different parts of the processors for actually 50 kilowatt range, but it's downscaled to 5 kilowatt and it actually doesn't change the ratio. So water gas shift is a major component. It occupies about 70% of waste in a processor, so obviously it has to be reconsidered. And our proposed prototype, which is a green line here, you can see that almost the main advantage can be gained here. This is almost half of the total volume of the processor. So water gas shift is actually reaction which takes place adiabatically in a large-scale reactor, and we want to do it actually with best time temperature, so we just follow equilibrium lines to get rid of this two-step system, which is normally used in industry, and to develop catalyst which will stay as good as in low temperature and high temperature range. Obviously, there are some ways to do it, and actually, the typical catalysts which are used now, you can see it here, it's well known. But of course, the disadvantage here, so this catalyst cannot be used in low temperature range due to low activity, and this catalyst cannot be used in high temperature range due to sintering problems. Another important issue is, of course, that they are pyrophoric, so in case of exposure to air, we need to large temperature rise, and also it needs a kind of step up conditions before we can run the process. So our approach here is to part is done by Colasign, a center in Apatiti, which is responsible for development of Catalyst. And we are in Poland working on mainly development of reactor itself and also integration with other parts of Eurostat. So why we used typical carbide? It's of course expertise of group in Apatiti, because we are the only group in Russia who can do this type of depositions, to the best of my knowledge. And secondly, of course, because we want to improve the system compared to present state of art, which you can see here. And of course, we don't want to use a pyrophoric, so this main advantage of our system. And also, compared to this system, of course, we have rather low bare key surface area produced by this method. So that's why we actually use microstructured reactors. And we can increase surface area not by increasing the area of wash floor, but simply increasing geometrical area if the microchannels would be in a range between 50 and 100 microns. So it is feasible at the moment, and it's not that easy anymore. Another issue, of course, a price, why we cannot use this catalyst, you can see here. So if we start with novel metals, which are typically used now in also research in many groups, and you've seen other publications growing, but if you consider the price compared to standard case, you are far too above the typical range. So you need either high dispersion or really a catalyst which contains approximately 1,000 times less a metal compared to copper at the moment. And to my opinion, this is rather unfeasible at the moment. So molybdenum is rather a good choice because if you make carbide or heat, the price is not so high, but the properties are very close, the electronic properties are very close to noble metal systems. So there are a few ways to do it. Of course, we can start from our oxide via reduction to nitrate available carbide. Also, we tried direct reduction with hydrogen methane, and also it can be done this way via electrochemical synthesis. And this is actually my main focus of the talk today. So if you start via nitrate and also via oxide, you actually get different crystallographic structures, and catalytic activity varies by an order of magnitude. So actually, there are only one way that we found the correct way to do it. So this electrochemical cell itself, so we use it in Apatiti, and actually our microstructure reactor becomes a cathode in this reaction, and applying correct conditions, you can actually make a carbide. So I would like you to visit our poster, which will be presented later on today. This is poster in session 3 in 14, so this is particularly devoted to electrochemical synthesis, so I will not go into details here. And I think Professor Kuznetsov can highlight this more details. So our reactor itself system was actually constructed in Eindhoven, and we used a typical plate of molybdenum, which has a carbide layer of only, let me say, 500 nanometer, and they are positioned at equal distances from each other in order of between 50 and 100 microns, so you can actually make a big step of this plate, which still can be done rather easily. And a poor catalyst itself are as a porous, a DAT surface area about 20 meters square per gram, which is still far below the standard catalyst, but I already mentioned we can make this surface really large. It's just only model system, but in a final system can be increased by factor of 10. So XRP analysis shows that depending on the synthesis, either you go via nuclear fluoride or via molten salt synthesis, sometimes you get different structures. And obviously, the best one we found is hexagonal molybdenum carbide, which is represented here. And if it doesn't contain any impurities, according to the browser 3, which was presented previously, the catalytic activity remains rather stable, as you might see here. So this is actually a typical catalyst produced via oxide growth, we call CDR. After about 24 hours, catalytic activity drops by a factor of 4, and then we need a reduction step. So this is rather difficult to implement. Pure carbide has activity long term about 400 hours without any decrease of activity. But of course, it's still a little bit less originally from oxide growth. So here another comparison between our catalyst. So you can see that the standard copper centoxide catalyst, it cannot go faster as a sintering. We also have our two carbides. This is usually reactor occupied, part of a reactor occupied of a catalyst. Yes, of course, we need some metal framework in order to position our catalyst. So, but I already mentioned this can be increased by a factor of 10. And when you already see the volumetric CO inflow rate, even in this non-favorable reactor design, is already comparable to the case of commercial catalyst. However, there's still some room to improve it by playing with temperature gradient. So for this, we need, of course, detailed kinetic studies, so we have to know how reaction rate depends on major parameters, like CO partial pressure, water partial pressure, and, of course, also hydrogen and CO2. So actually, our students, during the last 2 years, made a detailed kinetic study on this catalyst, and we found out that the best way to describe the system is just redox model. So the total reaction rate actually consists of two terms, which can be assigned to reaction rate on oxidized and liquid sides, and also relative amounts of these sides on the catalyst. But in real industrial conditions, actually, all catalyst is reduced because you have excess of hydrogen, normally between 40 and 60%. So this model can be actually run to such a simple model, which actually has a unique equation of hydrogen and power 2, which we also observed in our experiments, and we actually saw this rather reproducible effect on redox reaction, actually. So this also an effect of what I can describe. You can see there is a good peak about 200 data points here in the operation window compared to the real case. So this is actually we consider rather good. And now we can use this model indeed as a forward real conditions here to define the maximum reaction rate at different CO conversion. So of course, this is reaction exothermic and equilibrium limited. So as conversion proceeds, reaction rate decreases. So actually what you have to do, you have to follow this red line, which provides you an optimal temperature gradient. And if you need to do so, this is another representation of the same plot. So you can see here, the blue line represents the isothermal case, and the green line represents this prescribed optimal temperature profile. So you can see up to 3 times gain in the reactor size can be reached. So it means already in this case, it's not yet optimal catalyst, we have already reached our goal. However, we still have some room, including the surface area. So main conclusion of my talk, so just I'm convinced you that you and so we advise a new development in this area. So far, the catalyst itself and the lithium carbide method itself are rather unique and very promising, not only for water gas shift reaction, but we can also try to do the different application upstream and reforming, and maybe also for other type of selective methanation, if they get the of course, used at high temperature. And in this particular case, of course, the coating itself was rather active and rather stable in this deep range, which is, of course, the optimum range between high and low temperature range. So the reactor size can be decreased considerably. So I'd like to thank my students, Ilkont Mok and Sylvester Rapp and Maria Savic, who actually did the experimental work, and our technical staff at Bombic, our funding agency, and all of you for your attention. Thank you.
We have time for a couple of questions, please.
Questions, please.
Good
who used to defend the intermediate where the state was? Because there's an argument with some influence from the proposed scheme on the initial level of weapon substance against. So do you use any racial improvements for, I mean, between the capitalists and between the ongoing supporters?
So you mean do we need that diffusion barrier between carbide and molybdenum?
Right, this will.
But obviously, molybdenum carbide is only porous outside, so it itself protects molybdenum from oxidation, but actually conditions of water gas shift are acid retention, so we don't need to protect it particularly in case of oxidation reaction. Obviously, this reactor is good not from oxidation catalysis.
Okay, Eugenie, thank you for your interesting presentation.
Okay, let's move now to the result of this presentation. So the next talk will be with nanostructure catalyst based on mesophores metal silicate. So this is a contribution from the Top Shelf and Tomkin Institute of